Posey.
Thank you. And I really appreciate Congresswoman Johnson for holding this hearing. My questions are for Mr. Torres. Grid security is America's security. Do you agree with that statement?
I do.
Thank you. Any component plugged into the grid must be beyond reproach and ideally be sourced from trusted suppliers that are not affiliated with, controlled by, or manufactured by an adversarial country like China. This approach will support our energy independence. On page 8 of your testimony, you rightly mentioned that the new rise in cybersecurity vulnerabilities are real, especially as it relates to new energy technologies. And one trend that it is a challenge for the system resilience, according to you, is the loss in control and knowledge of the technology supply chain. Could you explain to this committee how the Department of Energy has a system reliance challenge involving the loss in control and knowledge of the technology supply chain?
Sure. What I meant to say there, maybe I can elaborate on that, is the fact that the grid and elements that we're putting in the grid are driven by the market. And we operate, when we procure energy components in a global market. And even when we purchase equipment and systems today from a U.S. vendor, that doesn't necessarily imply that everything in that system or device is all manufactured by that vendor, because they typically buy subcomponents, other software elements from vendors that can be global. They could be centered in other countries. There could be chipsets, there could be firmware, there could be software and other pieces of hardware that comprise a system that we don't necessarily always have full control over. So understanding and providing some sort of guidance for how we can track what goes into those critical elements, especially when we're talking about things like black start, and you know, if the power grid entirely blacks out, it could take days to weeks, maybe even longer to restart a large part of the grid. And so we have to be fully aware and confident in everything that's in the grid when we're restarting it. So those kinds of things I don't believe exist, especially for those kinds of procedures don't exist in the policies and directions of where we're going with some of the newer technologies. We don't have the same expectations for some of the new technologies yet. We've been managing nuclear power plants and coal plants and gas plants for a long time. And we know how to do that. But we don't necessarily understand, as technologies are evolving, what we need to do for things that may be added to the grid in the future.
Yeah, I hope that we can all agree it would be stupid for us to have power grids full of Chinese chip components. On May 1st of 2020, former President Trump signed an executive order 13920 to prohibit the acquisition of installation of certain bulk power system electric equipment sourced from foreign adversaries that pose a demonstrated undue risk. Are you familiar with the bulk power executive order that was signed and suspended by the current president until April 20th with executive order 13990?
Yes, I am.
Do you know if the current administration plans to reinstate the executive order to secure America's grid security?
I do not know.
If you find out, would you be kind enough to let us know?
I will work with the Department of Energy to provide the information they can.
Thank you very much, Mr. Torres. Madam Chair, I yield back.